On August 18, 1920, the 19th Amendment to our Constitution was ratified by the states. This achievement was the result of the courage and determination by generations of women and men. We truly walk in the footsteps of giants.
The Turning Point Suffragist Memorial is going to be the first national memorial to pay tribute to the women who fought for 72 years to win the vote. That created the largest expansion of democracy the country had ever seen. Yet a lot of people don't even know who these women were. We like to call this the best kept secret in American history.
It's important for people to remember this moment, indeed to celebrate it, when women achieved the right to vote. But all of us must remember the shoulders that we stand on. We simply would not have been here without the work that they did, the vision that they had, the success that they achieved.
The Turning Point Suffragist Memorial is important to Virginia because it is a tangible reminder that our voices and our votes matter. It is an opportunity to acknowledge those whose voices have not been heard, whose tremendous contributions to our great nation haven't been acknowledged. We have recognized the great significance of the suffrage centennial throughout this year. We proudly lit the Executive Mansion in purple, white, and gold to celebrate.
Having something like the Turning Point Suffragist Memorial will bring attention to this really significant history and hopefully help us Americans better appreciate these stories and these incredible women.
This is a story that really needs to be told. The story of the suffragists, the stories of the picketers that were arrested for picketing the White House and being sent to the Lorton prison, that all happened right here.
It isn't something that's been in the history books. There are few memorials, less than 10% of the memorials in this country are to women. We are not represented.
We want you to feel like you were there, like it was 1917 or the 1920 era. So a lot of the memorials designed with that in mind. So you have the bronze statues. Each of the information stations is designed to look like it's a newspaper article from the time. I really wanted you to feel like you were in the moment, that you could have been living in the 1917 era and feel what they felt. We will actually have a 24-foot section of the actual White House fence that the women picketed in front of in 1917.
Turning Point and Nova Parks are the very first entities to get a section of the actual White House fence. And the piece of White House fence that we are getting was actually there when the suffragists were standing in front of it with signs very pointedly asking President Wilson to give women the right to vote.
People can pose in front of the fence, they can look at it, they can understand this is living history, this is real.
Fairfax County is very rich with history throughout the county. We have so many landmarks and things for people to visit. Getting national attention for what we're doing, that strategically where this memorial is very helpful to encouraging people to come to our area and spend some time here.
We are working with Visit Fairfax, which is funded by Fairfax County Tourism. We are working with the Virginia Tourism Corporation throughout the state.
Virginia's history is much richer, much more diverse, and much more complicated than what many of us were taught in school. And this memorial will be an important resource for teaching history that accurately reflects the stories and experiences of everyone.
The Turning Point Suffragist Memorial is only the beginning. Once the memorial is built, we have plans to create a Turning Point Institute where we bring in women, young girls, and kind of train them in some of the traits of the suffragists and how to become leaders themselves.
My name is Alice Paul Tapper, and I'm 12 years old. Without my mom naming me Alice Paul, I probably wouldn't have learned about her story. I really saw what the suffrage movement was like for those women, and it inspired me to be brave in my class. I wrote an op-ed in the New York Times about my experiences and raising my hand in class. And someone from Penguin Books saw my op-ed and asked me if I wanted to write a book.
I have a young daughter who's going into middle school next year. And she needs to understand that, you know, there were a lot of sacrifices made by a lot of people to achieve equality in a lot of areas. And we certainly understand in times like this that there's still more work to be done.
And people are still trying to fight to have a voice in their government. And this just shows you that this is a continuing battle that we must still fight.
Because of a pandemic in our country, we've lost some funding that's not going to allow us to finish it this year. But we're going to finish it. We absolutely intend to move forward. We are under construction. We have a big portion of the memorial finished.
It's a hopeful project. It's a project about the future and hope and education to me, because that's the way that people succeed.
This memorial will stand in perpetuity to honor the bravery, the courage, and the commitment that these women had. It's going to be a beacon to young people growing up, understanding that this is the sacrifice that was made for them.
We really need help to finish this suffragist memorial. We hope these stories have really inspired you. We hope to educate future generations about leadership. If this interests you and you want to support us, please go to our website,